अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस फिफ्थ लेक्चर। एंड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग द फ्रैक्शनल फ्लो इक्वेशन, एंड बेसिकली वी हैव सीन दैट व्हेन वी डिस्प्लेस ऑयल बाय वाटर और ऑयल बाय गैस, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फ्रैक्शनल फ्लो अराइजेज। एंड द फ्रैक्शनल फ्लो इज द रेशियो ऑफ द फ्लो रेट ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर इंजेक्टेड फ्लूड डिवाइड बाय द टोटल फ्लो रेट। सो फॉर वाटर बेसिकली वी हैव सीन दैट फ्रैक्शनल फ्लो ऑफ वाटर इज इक्वल टू फ्लो रेट ऑफ वाटर डिवाइड बाय द टोटल फ्लो रेट, विच इज द सम ऑफ वाटर फ्लो रेट प्लस ऑयल फ्लो रेट। एंड वी नो दैट फ्रैक्शनल फ्लो कॉन्सेप्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू एस्टिमेट द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट प्रोसेस। सो व्हेन वी आर इंजेक्टिंग वाटर टू डिस्प्लेस ऑयल और गैस टू डिस्प्लेस ऑयल, वी आर कंसर्न दैट हाउ मच रिकवरी एफिशिएंसी इज एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट प्रोसेस, व्हाट विल बी द पोजीशन ऑफ द फ्लडिंग फ्रंट एट डिफरेंट टाइम्स ऑफ इंजेक्शन, एंड व्हेन वी एक्सपेक्ट द ब्रेक थ्रू ऑफ योर इंजेक्टेड फ्लूड इन द प्रोड्यूसिंग वेल, एंड व्हाट इज द सैचुरेशन ऑफ द वाटर और गैस बिहाइंड योर फ्लडिंग फ्रंट। सो दीज क्वेश्चंस can be answered through fractional flow equation, and we will see in coming slide that how basically we answer these questions. So this equation, which is the simplest equation, and we have seen that this equation has been derived using the Darcy equation, and the Darcy equation we have used, which has also include the effect of gravity, and we know that the gravity either increase the production rate or decrease the production rate. So simply using the Darcy equation, subtracting the two equation, including the effect of capillary pressure, we come to this equation, which is basically the fractional flow of water. And to estimate fractional flow of water, we need effective permeabilities, capillary pressure, the density difference and dip angle, along with the viscosities. As we have also seen that for the simplest case, when there is no dip, alpha is equal to zero, and basically when you have the when you do not have any capillary forces, so PC becomes zero. So the simplest equation for the horizontal flow of both oil and water, this equation of fractional flow of water becomes this, and for this equation you only need relative permeabilities and the viscosities. And we have also seen that relative permeabilities are generally reported for a reservoir, and relative permeabilities are reported against the saturation. So for water saturation, both relative permeability of oil and water are reported. So we have also seen the procedure of calculating FW. So you basically assume some water saturation, and against the water saturation you read the relative permeabilities of oil and water from the graph, and once you know the relative permeabilities and you know the viscosities of oil and water, you calculate FW against E saturation. So for E saturation you will have a one value of FW, and you plot this graph of FW against the water saturation. Again this graph basically is for a particular system. You have fixed value of viscosity of oil, you have fixed value of viscosity of water, and you have fixed values of relative permeabilities. Obviously if viscosity of water changes, this FW will change. If viscosity of oil changes, this FW will change. Similarly, if wettability and or the capillary forces of reservoir changes, obviously this FW will change. So FW is dependent on water viscosities, oil viscosity, relative permeabilities, wettability, interfacial tension, dip angle, injection rate and other parameters. So FW basically changes when any of the parameter changes. So even in the simplest case, it is dependent on relative permeabilities and viscosities. If any of these parameter change, FW will change. And obviously in the complex version, when FW is dependent on capillary forces, dip angle, densities, injection rate, so if any of this term changes, FW will change. And basically we will see how do we estimate FW when things change. This is basically one of the uses of FW curve. Basically when you are displacing oil by water, and basically you are continuously injecting water from the injection well. Water is moving inside your pay zone and displacing oil towards the production well. You are concerned basically what is the saturation of water at the front. So whether front is moving with 60% water saturation or whether the front is moving with 80% water saturation. Higher the saturation of the flat front, the more recovery you can expect. So one of the uses of this fractional flow curve is to estimate the saturation at the front. And how? Basically, you have this fractional flow curve which you have calculated through the equation for a particular system. So you will draw a tangent to this fractional flow curve. This is a tangent basically that is from the zero FW and connect and touching your FW curve. So at the point of contact of this tangent to your FW curve, you will read SWF and FWF. So this SWF is the saturation of water at the front for that particular system, and FWF is the fractional flow of water at the front. Obviously, this number will change from system to system. If the viscosity of water changes, this SWF will change. If the viscosity of oil change, this SWF change. Similarly, if the wettability and other parameter changes, this SWF and FWF change. So for any system, you need to draw a tangent, and from the contact you need to read SWF and FWF. These two are the most important properties you estimate from this fractional flow curve, and SWF is the saturation of the water at the front. The second important use of the fractional flow curve is to calculate the average water saturation behind the front, and for that again the tangent you have drawn. So you need to read the SW at FW is equal to 1. So that you extend the tangent to FW is equal to 1, and from FW1 basically you read the saturation of water, and this is the saturation, the average saturation of water behind the front. So these two important things are calculated from the fractional flow curve, and this is basically the explanation. If you are injecting water from the injection well, as you can see, and water is obviously moving inside the reservoir or pay zone, and the water, as you can see, water is moving with a particular saturation, and that particular saturation is called SWF. So SWF is the minimum saturation required by the water for move in the reservoir. So water will not move in the reservoir when the saturation is lower than this SWF. Obviously, this SWF is different for different system. So whatever the value of SWF, you can estimate from the fractional flow curve. So the saturation at the front is called SWF, and obviously with time the position of front is changing. So initial days, this as the water bank will be near injection well. At some later stages, this water bank will move towards the production well and will be somewhere near production well. So with time, the position of your front will change from injection well towards production well, and through fractional flow equation you can also estimate the position of the front at this particular time. So SWF is the saturation at the front, and this is the saturation of water behind the front. So basically this number, the SW bar, so SW bar is the saturation of water, the every saturation of water behind your front. Again, we will see the importance in coming slides. At the time of breakthrough, obviously this water bank will move continuously, move from injection well towards the production well, and a time will come sooner or later this water bank will reach at your production well. And when this time occurs, we call it the breakthrough time. And at breakthrough, basically, again, initially, obviously, this water bank will reach to the production well, and the water basically will spread behind this front. So if you need to estimate the recovery of oil through this water flooding, you use this formula, which requires the average saturation of water behind the front. And we know that we can estimate the average saturation of water behind the front through fractional flow equation. SWR, the Kunet water saturation, or the initial water saturation, which is constant. So by knowing this SW bar, which is the average water saturation behind the front, we can calculate the recovery factor at the time of breakthrough, the water breakthrough. Water breakthrough means the time when your water has reached at your producing well. And similarly, we can also calculate the water cut, that how much water will produce at the water breakthrough. So FWF, the FWF is basically is estimated through this fractional flow curve, and we have seen that FWF is basically the fractional flow of water at the flood front. So FWF, when this water bank or the water front reach at your producing well, before that no water was coming to your producing well. As soon as your flood front reaches at your producing well, the water production will rise, and water production will rise to FWF, is the fractional flow of water at the front. So water production will increase from 0 to FWF. So since we know that FWF is measured in reservoir unit, in order to calculate the water cut at surface unit, you need some sort of formation volume factor, and this is the formula to calculate the water cut in surface unit. So these are the basically uses, the basic uses of the fractional flow curves. You estimate the average saturation of water behind the front, and we have seen how do we estimate the average saturation behind the front by reading the SW at FW is equal to 1 for your tangent. First you draw a tangent, and when this tangent has reached to FW is equal to 1, you read the value of saturation against this FW1, and this is the average saturation of water behind the flood front, and this is used in this equation to calculate the recovery factor. FWF, we know we can calculate from the point of tangency, and this is basically will be the water cut at the time of breakthrough. So this is again the explanation. For example, at different times your front will be at different position. At early time of your injection, the flood front will be near injection well. As time of injection increases, the flood front will move deeper into the formation, and will move towards the production well. And at the time of breakthrough, as you can see, you will have water cut increases from 0 to FWF. And again, the saturation of the flood front will become the saturation of breakthrough at the time of breakthrough. Let's do an example. Oil is being displaced by a water in a horizontal linear system under diffuse flow condition. The relative permittivities are given by this equation. Kr naught at a particular saturation is equal to Kr naught dash, and S naught minus SOR divided by 1 minus SOR minus SWIR and power square, power 2. And similarly, KRW is given by this equation, where KR naught dash and KRW dash are called the end point relative permittivities. Again, in this example, you are not provided the curves, and instead of the curves, you are given this correlation, and you will be calculating the relative permittivities against each saturation through this equation. And the pressure is maintained during the displacement process, and the formation volume factor and the viscosities are also given to you. So you are provided the relative permittivity curves through you will calculate obviously through this equation, and that the fixed point, the relative permittivity endpoints and the saturation endpoints are given to you. The residual oil saturation, the equivalent water saturation, similarly the formation volume factors and the viscosities are provided to you. And you have been asked to calculate the FW, neglecting the capillary pressure. And first of all, you will calculate the FW for the base case, and the viscosity of oil is 1 centipoise. And then you have been asked to calculate FW by increasing the viscosity 10 times higher. And you are also asked to calculate the oil recoveries at the time of water breakthrough for the two cases. One is obviously for viscosity of oil is equal to 1 centipoise, and for the other case when viscosity of oil is 10 centipoise. So data is given to you and you have been asked to calculate FW, and through basically Excel you have been asked to calculate this FW. So you enter all data in Excel file, the residual oil saturation, Kuhnert water saturation, endpoint, relative permittivities are given to you, formation volume factor of oil, viscosity of oil, formation volume factor of water, viscosity of water. So you enter all this point, all these numbers in the cells, and these numbers which are colored in red are the fixed number. We will not be changing during the calculation. Viscosity of oil and viscosity of water can be changed. So these numbers are not colored in red. And we know the formula for the horizontal flow. 1 divided by 1 plus KR naught divided by viscosity of water. Similarly, KR naught KRW into viscosity of oil. We have seen this formula. So we will be using this formula to calculate FW. So again, first we assume some saturations. So since we have two fluids in the reservoir, one is water, other is oil. So saturation of water, for example, we will start from 0.2 because the initial water saturation is 0.2. So at initial water saturation, you will have 80% oil in reservoir. So this is the initial condition before injecting water. So you will have 80% oil in the reservoir with 20% Kuhnert water saturation. Obviously, when water saturation is increasing from 0.2 to 0.25, oil saturation is decreasing because sum of these two saturation will be equal to 1. So these are some number you have assumed, starting from the minimum water saturation till the maximum water saturation, and the maximum water saturation is 80% because 20% is the residual oil saturation. So water saturation will increase from 20% till 80%. So you have selected some numbers between the minimum and the maximum water saturation, and obviously the oil saturation is decreasing. Water saturation is increasing, so oil saturation is decreasing. So 1 minus SW will give you the S naught. So this saturation of oil is automatically calculated through this saturation of water. In this example, we are not provided with the relative permittivity curves. Instead, we are given the correlation. So we will first estimate KRW and KR naught against each saturation. So formula is known to us. In this formula, we know that KR except S naught, all other terms are fixed or constant. Similarly, in KRW equation, except SW, all other terms are constant. So you basically calculate KRW through the formula, and when we work on Excel, we give the cell address, as you can see, G10. So G10 basically is the KRW dash, which is the end point relative permittivity of water. And since it will not change from cell to cell, we have pressed F4. So dollar sign, you can see dollar sign, and dollar sign means that this is the fixed value for all calculations of KRW. So similarly, all values are given. So you know, except C24 is just SW. So except C24, all other inputs have have made fixed by pressing F4, and it means that these numbers will not change in the subsequent calculation. So KRW is calculated at SW, and when you double click form numbers, Excel will automatically calculate KRW against e-saturation. So if you hadn't fixed these endpoint relative permittivities and SWI and SOR, this will also change with subsequent calculation. So G10, as you can see, is fixed in first calculation also, in second calculation also, in third calculation also. The only thing that is changing in all calculation is the C24 or C25 or C26, which is the saturation of water. So this is the simplest way to use Excel file. You can fix any cell which is fixed in all calculation by pressing F4. The dollar sign will appear against the cell value, and which will indicate that this value will not change for subsequent calculation. You can plot the graph, relative permittivity graph, against all saturation you have calculated KRW and KR naught. So by selecting the values from select data, you can easily plot the graph. On x-axis you have SW, on y-axis you have KRW and KR naught. So since you have two KRW and basically two values on y-axis, basically two graphs are plotted on one sheet. So this is basically the KR naught and KRW response against saturation of water, and obviously you can, from the design, if you go to design and layout, you can label it. On x-axis you have saturation, so chart title, axis title, these are basically numbers. You can format your graphs later on. So after calculating the relative permittivities, we are required to calculate FW for this viscosity of water and viscosity of oil. So FW, the formula is known to us. So against each saturation we have calculated the relative permittivities, and now we can calculate the FW. So for first point, FW will be 0. For later stage, FW simply the formula of 1 divided by 1 plus KR naught upon KRW and viscosity of oil divided by viscosity of water. And we know that in all calculation of FW, viscosities are constant. So again, when you give the cell address of viscosities, you will also press F4 again to make the values constant. So G14 is the viscosity of water, and you see a dollar sign is also before this G14, which means that this number is constant. Similarly, G12, the viscosity of oil. Similarly, you have also pressed F4 against viscosity of oil. L25 and G25 are the relative permittivities. Against each cell, you see L26, G26, so the cell address is changing against each saturation, because you want to calculate FW against different saturations, and against all saturations you have different relative permittivities. But this viscosities are not changing. Again, I will provide this Excel file to you when I upload these lectures. The Excel file will be available to you, so you can also check the calculation, and you can also see the formula. And you can, by doing the practice, you will know that it is very easy. So the fractional flow of water has been estimated against each saturation, and you have plotted the graph. The fractional flow of water is on y-axis and saturation is on the x-axis. So you will have this basically response of this particular system. So now come back to the presentation. Again this exercise example will be provided to you, Excel file will be provided to you, this presentation will be available to you. Don't worry about the formulas and other things. You can see it. So simply you enter these numbers in the Excel file. You first estimate relative vulnerabilities, and this is the formula of FW, and basically you calculate FW against each saturation of water. You can do it manually also, but manually will take time, so it is advised that you use the Excel file for your practice. So you plot this saturation of water against this FW, and this is the basically the response for 1 centipoise oil. We know that we can calculate something from this FW curve. We need to draw a tangent, and a tangent will give you the SWF and FWF, plus it will also give you this the saturation at FW is equal to 1. So we know that we can calculate SWF and FWF, so we draw a tangent, and from this point of tangency we estimate this SWF, the saturation of flood front, which is 0.64 in this case. So when the oil viscosity is 1 centipoise and the water viscosity is 0.5 centipoise, the saturation of the flood front is 0.64, and the procedure is written over here. Okay, draw a tangent to FW curve, read the SW from x-axis at the point of tangency, and to estimate the saturation of water in the flooded region, similarly you extend that tangent and basically read the saturation value at FW is equal to 1. So the average saturation behind the flood front at the time of breakthrough is 0.72. So these are two important numbers you have you read from the FW curve which you have plotted for a particular system. So for same thing you need to do for the 10 centipoise oil. Since you have the Excel file, working with Excel file is very easy. You have all calculations on this Excel file, so you are just only required to change the viscosity of oil. So from you change 1 centipoise to 10 centipoise, all calculation will automatically change. Again, obviously these relative vulnerabilities have not changed because they are independent of viscosities, they are dependent on water saturation and oil saturation. So these relative vulnerabilities have not changed, but this FW has automatically changed. And since we have given the cell address G14 in this equation, and since we have G14 and G12 in this equation, and since we have changed the viscosity of oil, which is G12, and so the all calculation related to FW will automatically change. And since you have plotted the graph of FW of versus saturation, and you have given the cell address from this sheet, this FW curve will also automatically change. So this is the advantage of working in the Excel file. So this FW versus saturation for oil viscosity is equal to 10 centipoise. Again you can estimate the two things which are important for us. One is the saturation of the flood front, and in this case the saturation of flood front is 0.42. the saturation of water at the flood front is 0.42, which is much lower in the previous example when the oil viscosity was 1 centipoise. So when oil viscosity has increased, now you can see that the front is moving with less water saturation. We will see what does it physically mean. Is it good for us? Is it bad for us? We will see it in coming slide. But remember this number. Then this number is much lower as compared to the previous case when the oil viscosity was 1 centipoise. We haven't changed the viscosity of water. The water is has a similar properties as that of previous example. Similarly, the average saturation behind the flood front is 0.51. It's again much lower as compared to this case. The average saturation behind the flood front for viscosity of oil is equal to 1 centipoise was 0.72. So FW curve changes as we know that viscosity of either oil or water changes. In this case, we have changed the viscosity of oil and we have seen that it affects your SWF and SW bar number. So by changing the viscosity of oil, we have seen that our curves have shifted, and when the viscosity of oil was 1 centipoise oil, the curve was like this, and the viscosity of oil has increased, the curve has moved to the left direction. So obviously the question arises that which one of these is favorable for the displacement process. Again, obviously we are designing our water flooding project, and basically we know that we can play with the viscosities of water, for example, and you have to select an optimum water flooding project which gives you the maximum recovery, and you draw this type of fractional flow curves, and from the fractional flow curves you have been asked to provide the most optimum flooding project. So when different fractional flow curves are available, the one on the extreme right, the one on the extreme right will be the most favorable for the flooding project. So in these two case, 1 centipoise oil FW curve is basically is favorable for us. And why? Because the average saturation behind the flood front is 0.51 for 10 centipoise oil, which is much lower than the viscosity of oil equal to 1 centipoise. So recovery factor will be lower for viscous oil reservoir as compared to low viscous oil reservoir. So when the oil viscosity is closer to the water viscosity, the mobility ratio will be closer to 1, and when the mobility ratio is near to 1 or equal to 1, you have the perfect displacement. Water and oil both moving with the same velocities, and waterfront is behind your oil. And since we have seen for blue case, the viscosity of water is near this oil, and waterfront is moving with a much higher saturation, 0.64. So water is moving with a very high saturation, which means that it is displacing majority of the oil from the flooded zone. But in heavy oil case, we have seen that water basically is moving with much lower saturation, around 42%, which means that water is not displacing all of the oil from the flooded zone. So from the fractional flow curves, we can estimate the most desirable or the optimum flooded operation. So the curve on the extreme right will always be favorable for the displacement process. In this case, the curve for viscosity is equal to 1 centipoise. Again, you can also estimate the most favorable project by calculating the recoveries, and for viscosity is equal to 1 centipoise, you calculate recovery factor through this equation. SW, the air saturation behind the waterfront, is known to us, and SWIR, the Kunait water saturation, is given to you. So the recovery factor turns out to be 65%. So at the time of breakthrough, for first case, the recovery factor is 65%, and for oil viscosity equal to 10 centipoise for heavy oil reservoir, the recovery factor has decreased from 65% to around 40%. So everything is same. Rock is same, relative permeability is same, and water viscosity is same. Only the oil viscosity has changed, and you see that when oil has become viscous, the recovery factor has decreased. So obviously through fractional flow curve you have estimated this. So this is the use of fractional flow curves and equation that you can estimate the efficiency of a given flooding project. You can also estimate water cuts. The equations are known to you, and basically water cuts are calculated at reservoir condition and also at surface condition. So for oil viscosity equal to 1 centipoise, you first estimate FWF, and we have seen that FWF is read against SWF. So for first case the FWF was 0.86. So this is basically the method. From the point of tangency you read SWF from x-axis and FWF from y-axis. So for first case, when the oil viscosity was 1 centipoise, the FWF is 0.86. So FWF is calculated from the fractional flow curve, and water cut in reservoir obviously will be equal to 0.86, and at surface condition the water cut will be around 90% by using this second formula, which is water cut in surface unit. So 1 divided by 1 plus 1 minus FW into 1.1.86 into 1.5. So these formation volume factors are given to you. Fractional flow you have read from the fractional flow curve. Similarly, when the oil viscosity is 10 centipoise, you can also calculate water cut in reservoir and surface condition. And but again, you need to read FWF from the fractional flow curve, and this is FWF. At the point of tangency, you read SWF from x-axis and FWF from y-axis. So it is around 0.7. So for 10 centipoise oil, FWF is 0.7. So this is the water cut in reservoir units. So when you convert this water cut in surface unit, you have the formula, and water cut in surface unit is around 76%. So through fractional flow curves and equation, you can also calculate water cuts. You can calculate the saturation at the flood front. You can calculate the average saturation behind the flood front, and through average saturation behind the flood front, you estimate the recovery factor. So let's now check the effect of water viscosity on fractional flow equation. Obviously, when we are designing a water flooding project, we cannot play with the oil viscosity. Oil is very large, and we cannot change the oil viscosity of the whole reservoir. So the thing which we can change is the water viscosity. Again, we will calculate fractional flow for the previous example for different water viscosities. So I have selected three viscosities: 1 centipoise, 10 centipoise and 20 centipoise. Just to show how basically fractional flow curve is used. So again, you will go back to the fractional flow calculations in the Excel file. Since we have selected 10 centipoise oil, so you will make sure that viscosity of oil is 10 centipoise. We will be changing viscosity of water only. So first you will put viscosity of water 1 centipoise. Excel will automatically change all calculation of FW. For second calculation, 10 centipoise, when the viscosity of water is 10 centipoise, FW will automatically change. And when the viscosity of oil is 20 centipoise, FW will automatically change. So these are basically values which I have copied from the first sheet. So these are saturation of water, and these are FW for different viscosities of water. So when the viscosity of water is one centipoise, these are different FWs of against the saturation. Similarly, for water viscosity 10 centipoise, these are different FWs. For water viscosity 20 centipoise, these are different FWs. Plotting is very simple. You can select all these points, go to insert, scatter, enter this graph, and you will have the shape of the curves. On x-axis you have saturation, and on y-axis you have the FW values. I have format this graph, and this is the final version. On x-axis you have the saturation, and on y-axis you have FW, and these three curves are for different viscosities of water. Let's go back to the presentation. So these basically are three fractional flow curves for different viscosity of water. And again, if someone asks you, basically out of these three curves, which one is the most optimum or the favorable displacement process? So we know that the one on extreme right, so one on the extreme right, basically this green line, and the green line basically is for the water viscosity is equal to 20 centipoise. So the when the water viscosity is higher than your oil viscosity, remember that we have run these cases for fixed oil viscosity, which was 10 centipoise. So now when the oil viscosity is 10 and the water viscosity is higher than the your reservoir oil viscosity, you have the most ideal condition. So this is the case which is you should use ideally to enhance your recovery or to get the maximum oil from your reservoir. Again, this will be the piston like displacement case, and when you draw a tangent, you can calculate the saturation of water at the front, you can calculate the saturation of water behind the front. So all numbers will be higher for this third case when the water viscosity is 20 centipoise. It is also written over here that the most favorable displacement process is the case when the water viscosity is 20 centipoise. So that's how you use the fractional flow curves to design basically an efficient displacement process. And again, this is shown for different oil viscosity. So when you have the low viscosity, the curves are moving on the right direction. For water viscosity, when the viscosity of water is higher, the curves are moving to the right direction. This you need to remember for exam, that how fractional flow of water will change with water viscosities and with oil viscosity. So when water viscosities are increasing, you have the basically the efficient displacement. So when the viscosity of oil is higher, the FW basically will be on the extreme right. But the reverse will be for oil case. When the oil viscosity is lower, basically the FW curve will be on the extreme right. And basically we have also done this example that when the oil viscosity is lower, the FW curve will be on the extreme right. So the efficient displacement will occur either you have the low viscosity of oil or you have the high viscosity of water, in other words. So that's how you use FW curve. And obviously on the extreme right curve, you will have the maximum recovery. From the point of tangency, when you calculate SW and SWF and other parameters, for the extreme right curve, you will have the highest number of your oil recovery.